Your dog's aggression certainly needs to be resolved, but like a kid swatting at his sister, it's not enough to just say, no, don't bite. No, don't do that. We must be treating the root cause of your dog's aggression. Now, the truth is that dog aggression can occur for so many different reasons, but there is one unifying factor in many of them, and that is fear. That's why in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down why fear is actually causing your dog to aggress and what you need to do next to help resolve it. Coming up. What's up, guys? It's Jenna with Dog Liaison, where I coach you on how to enhance your dog's mental health. I'm a professional dog trainer, and on this channel, we break down scientific research in order to inform us on how to train dogs. In my signature program, the Recovering Rover Program for Dog Anxiety, I work with clients on how to resolve their dog's anxious behavior. Many of the dogs in the RRP have demonstrated aggression in the past, and we are working to change their perception of their triggers. And one of the things that causes aggression the most is fear. Now, to be clear, that's not necessarily just me, some person on the internet saying that. That is scientific fact. But the truth of the matter is that saying that fear motivates aggression is kind of an oversimplification. It's true, but it oversimplifies. And that's why in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down exactly what that means and how it applies to you and your dog at home. Specifically, what we mean when we say that your dog is fearful and that's what's causing his aggression. There is some sort of threat that he perceives is endangering him or his resources in order to survive. And this could be, for example, if your dog demonstrates resource guarding. He's aggressing because he perceives that there is a threat to a resource that he needs in order to survive, whether that is food or water, or something as simple as compassion. He is protecting his sanctuary or his person that's providing safety. It could be that your dog is experiencing territoriality, and that is to say that every single time a person comes onto his property, he perceives that they are there to do harm to either him or his resources. Now, perception of threat is what we actually need to be changing. In order to resolve your dog's aggression, we need to change their perception of the trigger so that they no longer feel like there is a danger to them or to their resources. But I want to take another scientific approach to this, because explaining fear goes far beyond just, oh, there's a perception of threat. There is a neurological and physiological experience to fear that is propelling your dog into action, which is causing him to aggress. So let's break that down a bit. For starters, the phrase fearful aggression is far too vague for scientific researchers. They're gonna need something a little bit more specific, a little bit more clear, and that's why they've created names like stranger-directed or owner-directed aggression or dog-directed aggression. We've given very specific names. And more than that, the reason we do that is because different forms of aggression have different markers on the dog's DNA. So owner-directed aggression is going to leave a different marker on DNA than, say, stranger-directed aggression. And so it's important that we have these different classifications so that we can see them appear on genetic mapping. And I actually did a full breakdown on a really awesome paper that happened in 2016 that examined the mapping of aggression and fearful behavior in dogs in DNA. And it's a wonderful study. If you're interested in doing the deep dive on that paper and how genetics play into aggression, I recommend you check out this video next. You can open that in a new tab and check that out after. Now, because there's different genetic markers for these forms of aggression, it would make sense and it would be easy to conclude that then we train all of them different because they're vastly different. But there is a unifying theme in these different displays of aggression, and that is something called epinephrine or norepinephrine. And you might know this as adrenaline. You might know this as the fight, flight, or freeze response. Now, adrenaline is the fear chemical. It is the thing that comes equipped in most species. The vast majority of species from our most ancestral species on the planet have come equipped with this magical superpower that identifies when a threat is in our environment that is potentially risking our life. And It is a superpower because it works almost independent of our logic. It works almost independent of what we actually sensibly experience. And so in many cases, this adrenaline kicks off and engages even when we don't mean it to. And so this is really the underlying unifying theme in all of your dog's aggression. When that trigger comes into the space, regardless of what logic says, his adrenaline, there's a little part in his brain that's telling him, oh, that's a danger. Oh, we're in danger. We better engage our fight, flight, or freeze system. And more often than not, if you're getting a display of aggression, this is as a result of the fight response. It is a physiological experience. It is not a logical one. In fact, it is happening in the most ancestral parts of your dog's body, and it is almost happening independent of what he logically thinks. And so it's really important that you understand that is an experience that is motivating the aggression. That internal physiological experience is causing your dog to demonstrate the growl, to demonstrate the bite, to demonstrate the lunge. It is not something that is necessarily always happening as a logical, I'ma fight you experience. Another thing to realize is that the physiological experience of adrenaline or that fight, flight, or freeze response can happen independent of emotions. And this is why it's kind of concerning when we start saying, oh, your dog is fearful. I know I've just spent the last 5 minutes talking about how your dog is fearful, and it's because adrenaline is the fear chemical, but fear is an emotion, and adrenaline works independent of emotion. It doesn't necessarily have to be influenced by how your dog is literally feeling. It can be just turned on and engaged by what the amygdala perceives as a threat to its livelihood. And so this is why, even if you have two dogs playing, if one becomes overly aroused and that adrenaline is coursing through his body, you could still get that aggressive display, even if your dog is quote unquote happy and silly. That level of excitement, that level of arousal has engaged the fight, flight, or freeze response, which is engaged the fight response, which is engaged aggression. Now, because many of the forms of aggression are rooted in this adrenaline rush, in this fight response, I don't personally train the different forms of aggression that differently. That's just a stylistic choice, and you may find other trainers that disagree with that, full disclosure. Personally though, I don't really train them that differently. There are some stylistic choices, but the techniques are effectively the same. And so for a full breakdown on how to resolve your dog's aggression, I recommend you check out this long video. I know it's long. It is jam-packed full of information, I promise you. But when we're talking about resolving your aggression, what I can say is that I want you to change how you perceive your dog's aggression from, oh, he's just misbehaved, or even potentially from, oh, he's just emotional. Instead, I want you to change it into a more neutral connotation to, he's perceiving a threat. This is what I have all of my clients do. Not to say that understanding your dog's emotions isn't important, it is, but as soon as we start saying like, oh, my dog is fearful, or oh, my dog is silly, or oh, my dog is happy, or over my dog is whatever emotion, the second that we start doing that, we're really stepping into some subjective activity, and we're steering away from science-backed data. Yes, it's true that there are some behaviors, for example, the hunched posture, the ears going back, the tail tucked. There are some behaviors that are scientifically correlated to fear. However, on the whole, when we are insinuating an emotion from a dog, that is highly subjective. And at the end of the day, only your dog, no trainer, not you, only your dog can tell us what emotions they're experiencing. And so I try to encourage my clients, and I'm gonna encourage you, to have a more neutral and objective perspective of what your dog is experiencing. And that way you can say it's a perception of threat. And if it's a perception of threat, then that means my job is to change the perception. If when the trigger comes into the space, my dog perceives it as a danger and that hazard avoidance signal goes off in his brain and the fight, flight, or freeze response is engaged, the logical conclusion, the logical fix to that is Change the dog's perception. Change the dog's idea of the trigger. When the trigger comes into the space, now he's safe. He no longer needs to engage that fight, flight, or freeze. That is getting to the root of your dog's aggression. Changing the perception of the stimulus of the trigger is getting to the root of your dog's aggression, as opposed to just saying, don't growl, don't bite, bad dog. You're wrong. And to learn how to change your dog's perception of his threat, I recommend you check out this video next. If you enjoyed this video, do me a favor, hit that like button, consider subscribing, hit the notification bell so you get notified when I drop a new video, and I'll see you guys next week.